So this is the one that we have. 1 year has been, 1 year has passed, and then we already have some big infrastructure project on the pipeline, already launched, already groundbreaking. And in 2011, for instance, there are around 50-something of groundbreaking project, new. And in this year, we are moving toward a new 32 groundbreaking projects at the total investment around 10 billion or 12 billion US dollars. So this is the one, so as example, next. So this is the project that has been launched in 2011 related to the toll road, port, and then new airport in Lombok even, and that's already operating right now. So it also in Kalimantan, we start also developing a new road and also a port there. In 2012, I mentioned to you there are 32 new infrastructure that will be groundbreaking or already groundbreaking. So I could mention to you there are now on the pipeline is a double track from Jakarta to Surabaya, and then some new seaport, that international seaport that will be also built in Jakarta, expansion of the existing seaport. And we have, as you see, you just arrived in Soekarno-Hatta, our international airport, then there are also expansion. And those expansion is coming from the state-owned enterprise, not coming from the government. And our policy right now, for facility, existing facility that already operated by state enterprise, then the expansion of the new facilities will be done by the state enterprise there. So that is, you know, all the infrastructure development that we would like to promote through the government funding, through the state enterprise, and also to private sector by using the public-private partnership of private-owned investment. Next, so I'll give you the showcases that we have in terms of disconnecting the economy. I have five minutes more, I guess. So connectivity in the island, connectivity to the economic zone, and also connectivity within the corridor. Next. So this is connecting inter-island. As you know, we are archipelago country, so we would like to promote the short shipping. Here, from Jakarta to Palembang, and then here also to Makassar, here to Banjarmasin. And then in terms of internal island, we have also some. So we would like to build more seaport or increase their capacity. And Indonesia is one country that we have three line for international line here. Here, we call it Alki-1. So this is through the Malacca Strait and South China Sea. And then the second one is International Lane 2, that is through the Makassar Strait. And the other one is the third one. This is, we have also the third international lane through Pacific here, Banda Sea and Pacific. So we are very strategic in terms of geographical position. So that's why that we need to build some of international port here, hub, around here, and around here. So that is the plan in terms of our international and also inter-island connectivity. Next, connectivity to the economic zone. So this is specific example for the corridors. Next. We just decided in 2011 a new two special economic zone. One is Seimangke, that is related to the crude palm oil industry, special economic zone. And then one is Kuala Tanjung, that is for the tourism industry. So for Seimangke, here, we as the connectivity working group is our job to assist the strategic plan to connect Semangke with other economic center in the corridors. That including the development of railway, new international seaport, and also tow route to the area. Next. So this is the location of Semangke around in Sumatra, around Medan. So we would like to build here a new international port that we call the Kuala Tanjung. Yeah. And this is the area where the crude palm oil, and there will be a industry, palm oil industry, will be concentrated here. Next. So this is the road development plan to the area that we already have in 2011 and 2012 to support this special economic zone. New national road, and certainly with that provincial and also district road, and most important one also the railway transportation to the area. Next. So this is the railway and port development plan to the special related to the special economic zone, and this one, the international seaport that we would like to build close to the this special economic zone, and this one, the new international airport that will be launched early next year to replace the existing international port airport in Medan. Next. So, and this one. This is another plan for the seaport, the international seaport that I mentioned to you, that will link this area, connect the Semangke Special Economic Zone to the global economy. Next. We also would like to develop a new special economic zone in Kalimantan. That is in the, we call it Maloy Industrial Zone, and this one also related to the palm oil and also some coal terminals there. Next. So this one, lane, international lane two, Kalimantan. So Maloy basically is here. So Maloy is here in East Kalimantan. And the same thing what we also we are doing in Semangke, we will do it also in Maloy. Next. So this is strategically located in the East Kalimantan, and we will develop for next. So 5,000 hectares will be developed in two stages in terms of industrial and also infrastructures development there. Next. So this is the plan on national road and tow road to support this Maloy industrial zone in Kalimantan. Next. And this one is for railway development also to the area. And this is more related to the coal transportation. Next. And this one is the Tanjung Lesung, the second economic zone that already established or agreed to be promoted. So this so-called is Tanjung Lesung, where located in West Java, close to the Sumatra. So there is an international lane here, and this is the location of the area, and with total 1,500 hectares, this area will have a 26 hotel, resort, condominium, and 1,000 prime canal of waterfront allotment. So this is specifically special economic zone for tourism industry. Next. And then we are moving to the more showcase in terms of Greater Jakarta. Jakarta is the center of Indonesian economy. And as you also see that there is an issue of connectivity congestion in Jakarta, while actually our 60% of logistics is through also Jakarta. So we need to expand our airport, our seaport, but still also avoid the congestion in Jakarta. So this is next. Okay, so Jakarta is here, and this is Greater Jakarta, and this is the airport as existing airport, Cengkareng, then we will need to build access railway from new airport from airport to the center of the city to avoid the situation of congestion that we have right now. Next. So right now, the traffic passengers in Soekarno-Hatta already around 50 million passengers per year, while actually the capacity is to the design capacity is only 22 million.
Can That's you why quicken, that Pak? Can yeah. you quicken?
We need to accelerate the expansion of this. Next. This is the access from the airport that we now prepare to build a railway from the Soekarno-Hatta Airport to the center of the city. Next. So this is the plan. And then also, next. This is related to our total development to our airport and also our seaport, Tanjung Priok. Right now, we also will expand the capacity of our existing seaport. So with that, we will need a new toll road that right now only here. Then we would like to expand a new outer ring road, a bigger one, sorry, this one. So this already started this year with this. So that is for next. So that is the beside the existing seaport, then we would like to also build a new international seaport. This is existing. It's already overloaded. And we would like to build a new one here, Cilamaya. It's around 200 kilometers east of current seaport. So this one will be our really industrial zone. Here, so can go here, and also the new one can go here. So that is, I think, as a showcase how that Indonesia, the challenge to Indonesia that with our as an archipelago country, we have so many islands, then how we are actually would like to develop our connectivity in order to support our economic growth. Our aspiration to achieve a growth rate at the level of 7 to 8% for the next 10 years. Thank you very much.